Good afternoon, Porto. Good afternoon, Portugal. You know, this is my first trip to Portugal. I've been in and out of Europe for long, you know. I've cleaned some of the pristine islands in Norway. So when I came in here, I was speaking to the team of Adrian and Taylor's, asking, is there a dirty beach in Portugal? The word dirty means different for different people. My Mumbai dirty meant 5.5 feet of garbage on the beach. So yesterday, with some teenagers from Portugal, I did step out. There were 80 of them, and we cleaned 2 beaches here. And let me give you a report card of what I saw. If the mayor is listening, he'll take cognizance of it and maybe develop a partnership between the citizen and the government to take it as we did in Mumbai. You don't have big plastics here, so you have these microplastics, plastics which have been left in the environment for long, maybe for 10 years, 20 years. And you see, a lot of people misunderstand beach cleaning. The other day, I was having a conversation with Adrian on the table, 8 of us, and I said, we must understand 2 things. One, beach cleaning is not about clean beaches. That's the last thing which you're looking for. When you clean a beach, the consequence may be a clean beach. But what you do is, you're calling people at a flashpoint of pollution. And we humans are very creative and ingenious. When we see the problem, we want to get the solution out. So when you go at a flashpoint of pollution, you start working in your head. Like what tailors do, you know, I visited Douro the other day, the first day of my visit. So Adrian and Anne were generous enough. So you get to these vineyards. I've never been. So you go there, you feel the aura, you feel the plant, you feel the soil. And they take you to those whole process of how you make my wine. So it interests me, can I have that glass of wine? It interests me saying that, oh, this is a very sustainable agriculture. A lot of people who work in that sector are sustainable. So it sparks a curiosity in you saying that this looks good for the planet. And this is exactly what beach cleaning does. But my work is misunderstood most of the time. You know, a lot of critics tell me, I must honestly share with you. They tell me, Afroz, you're cleaning the beach, you are at the fag end, you're mopping the floor all the time, the water keeps on coming. So you mop the floor. I tell them, it's not about mopping the floor. Of course you mop the floor if there's water. You should do that. You can't allow the water to stagnate. But by mopping the floor hard and fast, you are trying to find out where the water is coming from. What do I do to go back? And this is exactly what happened in Mumbai 3 years back. You know, I want to take you all to 2 key words which you, me, and people who live in this world must understand. People who work in the politician, who work as full-time politicians, people who are bureaucrats, lawyers like me, doctors, actors, common citizen. There are 2 words in English which started the thought process in me, what happened in October 2015. Confusion and hope. Mark these 2 words, and wherever I am, like if I'm in this conference, I start with this, you see. United Nations gave me the highest UN Environment Award. They said, you are a champion of Earth. And for what? Look at the confusion. For picking up garbage. How many times have you cleaned your houses and were you awarded? Did somebody come and tell you, oh God, you did a great job, you must get an award? You did it because it was your house. So the UN environment head at that time, Eric Solheim, looked to be confused. He said, Afroz, what a great work. It didn't end, the confusion didn't end there. My Indian folks got up after the UN award. They said, Afroz, you're the Indian of the year. Imagine 1.5 billion Indian of the year. It didn't stop at that. My local MLA, the local representative, she said, Afroz, I stay in a suburb of Mumbai called Versova. She said, Afroz, you are the pride of Versova. And finally, my law college woke up, and my law college says, you are the star alumni. Look at the confusion right from the UN to my college. And for what? For picking up garbage. I mean, how many of you all would get awarded for cleaning your house? So the idea is we all are confused. So what we do, if you are confused, you look for answers. So you look for answers. And then you think, when you take that journey of finding the answer, you will come to hope. As Katharina rightly pointed out, she fell in love in Porto. She found her love. I must tell her that I found my love at a dirty beach with the ocean. And there you go, the journey, which I call it date with the ocean, continued. So the journey begins, and then you look for hope. The hope is this world should become a better place than it was. As Adrian said, we want to wipe out the carbon print of this conference by planting trees. So you're taking that step to improve what is right now. And that's exactly what happened in Mumbai. Being a lawyer, I said, I'm confused. When I shifted to that apartment block, I said, oh my God, what do you do with this amount of garbage? I'll show you the video. It's a 4-minute clip, and then we'll continue the conversation. Just have a look of what happened in this 3 years. And technical guys who are listening to me, you can play both the videos back to back. So the first video is about what happened in 3 years. And the second video is actually what was the consequence of those 3 years of hard work. Can we have the AV, please? This is Mumbai. This is where I was born. This is where I lived all my life. I don't know if I could ever have imagined any life other than this. It's a fascinating world to live in Mumbai, a metro where people from different religious backgrounds. I love Mumbai, and I want to see the coasts of Mumbai and the oceans of Mumbai and of India and of the world relegated back to where it belonged, free of plastic. And I want to see my ocean healthy. I want to see my marine species and birds healthy. I have lived all my life on the coast of Mumbai, and particularly very adjacent to Warsaw Beach. And I remember when I was a kid, I used to come with my friends to play in this very beach. This is the consequential effect of convenience and economic prosperity. When I look back, I see only plastic. Plastic and plastic and plastic in my ocean. And what you see now is a tragic devastation. It's symbolic of the era which we live in. We have devastated our oceans. We have devastated the lives of the species which live in the ocean. And we have no right to do that. My right must come to an end where the rights of the other species begin. I must stop there. But I have not stopped. I have continued. I've invaded their houses. I've invaded their food habits. And I still remember my first day when I went to Jetty just to do a recce there. I actually sat there and cried. That morning, I said to myself, I don't know how long is going to be the journey. I don't know whether I'll be able to do it, because I was alone at that point of time. But I knew for a fact that I had to make a start. I need to bond with my environment. And that's the time I realized that I had snapped my ties with the ocean, you know. I could not even put my hand in that water. Then I decided I'm going to make an effort to build my personal bond with the ocean. And consequentially, if I'm able to provoke people around me who can come and do the same exercise which I wanted to do, that'll be wonderful. And that's how the journey started. I remember my first day, I picked up 5 bags full of plastic. In my country, we have 1.5 billion people. Imagine if 2 hands come on the beach, come on the ocean front, or come on the river body, wherever they are, the water, lakes. My country can become clean faster. In fact, the world can become clean. To my mind, it's always a date with the ocean. So when you're on a date, you are physically, mentally at your best. You look forward not only for that evening or that morning or that afternoon, for many more to come until death do us apart. It's almost 1.5 years we have been cleaning. United Nations has labeled it as the biggest beach cleanup in the world. We have picked out around 5 million kgs of plastic and filth from our ocean. I'm not going to complain to my government. I'm not going to complain to my judiciary. I'm not going to complain to anybody. My cry is inside my heart, and I don't have any complaints with anybody. It's me, it's me, it's me. We are in the 76th week of our journey of cleaning the beaches and ocean. A lot of people ask me, how long are you going to clean? This question is flawed because not many people in the ocean. This plastic will go into the deep sea, never to come back. Me and my volunteers will keep on doing it. Maybe this beach will become clean soon, but there are many other beaches which are in equally bad shape as Warsaw Beach was. We will continue our efforts on our beaches. It's about all of us. It's inclusive, and it will continue that way till our oceans are made plastic free. Can we have the second AVP too? Now, what you'll see is what happened in 3 years. This video depicted what we did for 3 years. This video is without an audio. Just look at the change. Yes. So what I was talking about is the word confusion. 3 years back, if that confusion continued in my head, what are the options for me to do as an individual? I'll list it out. Being a lawyer, the first thing comes is move the court. Tell the Chief Justice, look, the government is not working. Tell the court, pass an order, knock them out. The second option is go complain to your municipality. I'm sure the mayor here must be flooded with complaints from citizens. This is not happening. That is not happening. There's this usual citizens complaint box saying, my city needs this. This has not happened. The third option is you keep on writing letters to the government, as we do. You know, I'm very new to social media, so I see that on Twitter, Facebook. People are just complaining and complaining and complaining. Two things we do in this confusion, complain and hate. So if a person takes a step A, we say, we don't like it. It doesn't stop. We hate you for doing it. So this is the confusion which had already erupted in my mind when I moved to near that beach. So as I showed you, there are a few options to do. If I was a politician, a full-time politician, I would have taken that step there and there if I had seen the beach, because I knew the votes should come in. I was just having a conversation with Esther, what politicians do and don't do. Sorry, it's not a comment on all of them, but this is how the system works. But you saw what you saw, and I saw what I saw. So I said to myself, come on, let's begin the journey. It's something which actually, you know, it's a basic fundamental of your and my existence. We should first understand that we wear two hats. The hats are twofold, and we have got confused in that state. One is a hat of what you make for your living. I, as a lawyer, I have to go to the court, argue it out, get the briefing, get the money. Come to my home, a vacation, food, blah, 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 blah. Then there's a second very basic hat which we wear, which all of us, including me, have ignored. That hat is of a purely a species existing with other species. It's a one-to-one. I am a human, I exist, so does a whale, so does a shark, so does a turtle, so does a tiger. And this confusion has made the narrative so skewed that we assume we are here to make a living all the time. And I, for a moment, I'm not remotely suggesting that please give up your job and your businesses. We must continue what we do. But the narrative is so skewed that all the time you check your bank accounts. You check how much money you make. You check where are you in life. Did you ever check, as Adrian pointed out, what is your carbon print for the week or for the day? How much plastic you get into your life? What do you do with it? Like every time you step out here, you are given a coffee mug, a disposable use and throw. It baffles you if you keep on throwing millions and millions of coffee mugs are being thrown. Either it goes to the landfill or into the stomach of a whale or a shark. It eventually lands into a water body if not handled properly. So this whole narrative of dual hat as a species versus other species and as a species who want to make a living and the best of living, this is that confusion which is driving us to take on the politicians. You know, in my country, Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister, Every year, he goes to August 15th and January 26th, which are our independence, and shouts from the rampart fort, can you believe it? Please make India clean. Every year. I mean, has he to tell you, please make your house clean? He's worried his house is clean, my house is clean, my car is clean, my offices are clean. Now, in 21st century, we are being told by the Prime Minister of my country, please keep the country clean. And this is what happens when you go into this confusion zone. And it arises from the fact that as a child, you are trained by your family, your school, your college to say, be successful. And that success means in terms of wealth and power and money. Nobody ever told you that if you spend 2 hours at a beach listening to the ocean, you can be highly successful. You know, taking up from what Katrina said, a woman is always right. You know, I owe it to my mother. My mother was always right. She took me to a lake when I was 5 years old. And that's the language I learned early. She took me to a lake and she put me down near the lake and she said, look, this is the lake. This is a water body. And I, at 5 year old, was marveling at how water exists. And my father used to go fishing then. And I used to look at my father put a, you had these hooks those times. So he used to put a hook out. Now that's what is required in 21st century. In Mumbai city, we are 22 million. Let me give you some facts and figures from where I come from. 22 million, which is equivalent to some of your countries, you know, maybe 4 or 5 countries plucked together. Small city, 22 million. 60% of us in Mumbai live in human ocean conflict zone. So there you are, right at the coast. And all 60% do not have waste management. That's why I must praise the mayor here. Your beaches were very clean. My mayor has a lot to answer in Mumbai, to me and to everybody. The politicians there get very ruffled when you ask them, why is it so? 60% living in that human ocean conflict zone, and they get a plastic by dime a dozen every day. You have your milk pouches, your tea, and they are at the lowest of the economic strata. They're making in a day 10, in a month, 20 to 30 euros. Imagine making 2,000 or 3,000 rupees, 30 euros, 1 euro per day. Now, how do you tell as somebody who belongs to the same city saying that, can we work together? Can we do something? Your oceans, your lakes, your rivers, your forests have gone for a toss. And then people tell us on social media, among intelligentsia, saying, chase the Prime Minister. I should chase my Prime Minister Narendra Modi to make India clean. I should chase my chief minister. I should chase my elected representative. Mind you, I'm not saying I'm giving a free pass to them, but this is what the narrative at this point is. You vote, you pay your taxes, and chase them. Now, what the chasing does, it takes you more into that confusion zone. The chasing takes you more there, saying he's not doing it, so we are not liking it. Then you have the social media campaigns of different kind. And what you had to do is a simple thing. If you saw something, please go do it. You know, Norway's Council General in Mumbai wears a T-shirt. And he on the T-shirt, every cleanup he comes, he writes, just do it. So the first time he came, I asked, are you batting for Nike, Nike company? So he said, no, Afroz, I feel, this is what he said to me, and it struck a chord with me. He said, there are too many laws, too many policies, too many regulation. We are all the time told, this choice is not right, do this choice. This choice is not right, do that choice. And then nobody wants to even accept that choice which you are told. Like if somebody told you, please don't use plastic straw, you will get aghast with me. Afroz, how do you snatch my choice to enjoy my drink? Though we humans are known to put our lips to good use, we know how to use it. But we make a choice when it comes to enjoying food. All our intimate encounters are done without straws. But when it comes to enjoying that drink, we want a plastic straw. So he said there are a lot of policies, but nobody actually going there and saying that I take the onus. Which in English, there is a word called sense of belonging. You see, with your mother, with your father, if people who are having companion, your family members, your blood relative, your friends, you make that choice saying, I have a sense of belonging. If one of my friends wants to come over for dinner, subject to my time, I'll call him up. If one of my friends wants to have a coffee, we do that. But do you do that with nature? You know, I got a message yesterday, I must share with you, from a young Portuguese teen girl who was working with me. She was very shy. She came up to me during the conversation. She just said hi and went away. And on my WhatsApp, she sent me a message. She said, "Afroz, I was dying to hear this all my life, what I heard from you, saying that I need to be near the nature. The nature gives me so much." She said, "When I feel depressed, I'm around the ocean. When I feel unhappy, I go near the ocean. When I'm feeling a little imbalance in my life, I go near the ocean. And here you are, you're telling me, why don't you go and hug the ocean?" Look, a 16-year-old girl sending me a message. I don't know her at all. I met her precisely for 5 minutes at the talk, at that cleanup. And she's expressing herself. These are the young leaders who are between the age group of 14 and 18 trying to tell us something, but we have no time to hear. We want to hear the prime ministers and president. I mean, what new can they tell us than what they should be doing, actually? Should a president be rolling out a plan of action, or he should be acting and telling us, give me 3 years, I change the ocean for you. I will work around the forest. I will work around the lake. But they get you in more confused zone, saying that, this is not the answer. Let's look for something else. This is not the answer. So the debate goes on and on. Ask me as a lawyer, the court, when we stand to talk, we talk for hours before a judge, till the time the judge says, shut up, now it's over, I'll pass an order in your favor or against. Sit down, Mr. Afroz. So what we do there is we give different viewpoints to the judge. Can you latch onto this? Can you latch onto this? And that's exactly what is happening with Mother Nature, mind you. If it was an academic discussion, we have no problem. Lives of whales, sharks, turtles are at stake at this point as I speak to you. And you do not want to discard your throwaway cups. You don't want to give up on your single-use plastic because you want to enter in a confused zone on a debate that how should we handle it. When it requires a basic thing, go back to your home. Do not use those cups. Discard those plastic straw. Discard those plastic bags. These are steps which do not require an effort. But what? We want to hear the president of the country. Go to the Twitter handle of Mr. Trump. You'll know what's going on. Scientists are disbelieved. An attack is launched. And mind you, I'm not even remotely suggesting that he doesn't do. He does a lot of things for ocean. I work with a U.S. agency called NOAA, people who don't know, who work on marine debris very closely. NOAA is doing a fantastic work. President Trump is backing it up. But on the other aspects, and then you see the debates, conversations. So one puts a viewpoint, the other says this is not right. So I love you or I hate you or you are stupid. All these conversations will have to stop if you want to exist with other species. And this I say it purely from my experience at the ground level. I'll tell you some figures of what we do. Sorry, I must watch my watch. Otherwise, we lawyers talk a lot. You have to tell me, shut up. I'll give you some facts and figures from Mumbai. We picked up, me and my volunteers, thousands and thousands of Mumbaikar, unheard of, 23 million kgs of plastic and filth in 3.5 years. Imagine. And I'll tell you, I have no NGO and I have no bank account. Look at this. You'll tell me, Afroz, how do you manage to pick up? I have no NGO. I have not floated any bank account for this work. 23 million kgs left your ocean front, one. Number two, 80,000 young students from schools and colleges are working with me on a roaster system. Unimaginable for a city like Mumbai. It's easy to tear a check. So if you go to somebody, I do this work, they say, come on, take a check. Push your work further. We want you to grow. And here are people working in that city without a check. 200,000 households, as I speak to you, are getting churned into how to adopt circular economy. People who stay at the beach, who stay at the banks of the river. And what drives them? Are they not confused as you and me? Are they not confused as people who are on social media attacking the prime ministers and president? Why are they making a choice to come on the ground every week? Because then they see hope. You move from that zone of confusion to a zone of hope, saying that I did this much, so I could do that much. So it starts with, say, picking up a kg of plastic. Then you go on to your house. They go back and they, I'll narrate to you an experience of a young boy who was three or four years old. There's a Norwegian paint company called Jotun. The MD and chairman comes and cleans it up. She's got a kid. The kid comes and the kid told the mother at the beach right in front of me, in a very polite way, he said, don't get plastic at home. He picked up, He understood. A four-year-old is telling you and me, don't get plastic at home. See what's happening. And then we want to engage with the environment minister. We want to engage with the mayor. We want to engage with everybody but ourselves. The engagement must be with everybody else but ourselves. And why? We want to solve the larger problem, the big. It's a big problem, they tell me. Look at people in Mumbai. We have worked for 4 years. No government involvement. I have never approached a politician. I have never written a letter to a politician asking, can you do this? Because what could he not do which I should be doing in the first place? If you feel global warming, cut down on your meat. Meat which are produced in the factory, which creates a pressure on your climate. You make those choices. And hence, I always say, you see, life is not about alternatives. It's always about choices. Mark my word, look for alternatives. If you give up on this, what else? If you give up on this, it's yours, your and my choice. Simple, basic. And that's what I think this journey has to be. I come here to share my experience with you because I, you know, when Adrian invited me and Tanya was there, I was telling them that what could I say new to you all which you don't know? You know what is global warming? You know what is plastic pollution? We all have heard about it, just Google. But what could I narrate to you which I felt from my heart and head which could actually trigger in you something which you would like to do in your personal life? That 16-year-old girl from Porto sending me a message, I wanted to hear this all my life. That one message actually sealed my trip here to Porto. I said, she's got it right, she's understood, and she said, Afroz, I promise you that I'm going to take all these baby steps. A 16-year-old telling me. And this is what should be your and my existence. You see, I don't want to sound patronizing or preachy, but this is what I'm sharing, what I felt at the ground level. You know, I work with people. If you come to my house on a Saturday, Sunday, you'll find like hundreds of volunteers. My house is used as a base where people come, cook, have their tea, they go out. The whole camaraderie is this, that we need to bond with each other and then understand that we are species existing with other species and let's take it on who don't understand it. That law, that policy, that regulation, which is brilliant or beautiful, will exactly tell you to do the same thing. But that law will use coercive action on you. The law will say, if you don't do this, we will take action. You will have fine penalty or eventually incarceration. But the language which we speak, which I, you know, there was a great leader from India, Mahatma Gandhi, founder of my country, father of the nation. I derive inspiration from him. They are the people who told you and me that you don't need to have power and money to deliver, and especially where Mother Nature is concerned. You have to just go at the ground and do it. So we do that, all that. Coming back to what tailors and yet men are doing, there's a success story. He has also, and Adrian has left, I think. Adrian would be delighted to hear that. You know, when I walked into the hotel room, I was checking up what kind of hotel room it is, and they had the right bins, the waste bin. You see, yet men and tailor has moved from that. You don't find that in many hotels, five-star hotel. They're unsustainable. You can't even stay. Your towels are changed every day. Your bed sheets are changed every day. So when I entered, I looked, they had the right bins, so you could segregate in a hotel. Your segregation should start. Then you had the right glass bottles, so you did not have water bottles, plastic water bottles. Then I looked in the lobby, there was a solar panel. I said, wow. And then finally, I checked with Adrian, and he said, we recycle all the water here, so that the water is recycled and put back into the plants. Now, this is what tailors did to move from that confusion zone to hope. This is what thousands of Mumbaikers did in Mumbai, saying that we will move away from confusion to hope. Let's start that journey. And this is what I will urge you, whoever is here from wine industry or different backgrounds, I strongly suggest and urge you, please start this journey. It's high time we did that. Individual journeys must begin, and once individual journey begin, they become the building block. But I'll tell you what happened in Maharashtra, the state where I come from, and this is purely experience. When I was cleaning, in November 2017, I had suspended my cleanup. Just the cleanup. The other activities went on, training people up on circular economy, how to adopt. Some goons came to hit me. Can you believe for garbage pickup, you get goons, criminals who come say that, stop it. And I suspended it because being somebody who believes in nonviolence, I said, this is not the right approach. When I put the tweet out, the whole country arose in furore. In my country, there was like a big drama happening. The prime minister had to intervene. And one young leader from my local area came to clean with me. His name is Aditya Thakre. If you get time, please Google his name. And he's 27. He heads a political party. He cleaned and I was showing him all the plastic. He was in muck. And in the night, he called me back. He said, Afroz, I want to do something. I understood the problem. Look, a man who has an environment minister, his own environment minister, for 4 years, he has not taken the step to handle that plastic which is at the beach. And finally, I worked with him for 3 years, for 3 months. So from December 1st week, we started. March 22nd, we had a law in place where we put ban on some of the things which are single use. So the first time in India, we said, no more plastic bag, no more styrofoam, no more plastic straws. A work of 2 hours had such an impact on that young boy, who was a young politician, and he said, I'll take these steps. Now, there could have been ways to engage with him. I could have made a representation, written a letter to him, saying that, look, I'm working, why don't you do that? But the fact that I got him to the flashpoint of pollution in a very unfortunate circumstances, where the cleanup was suggested, it ignited a trigger in him. He said, Afroz, I have to do it. And that's what this journey from confusion to hope is. I think my time is up. The watch says so. Thank you for hearing me out. Sorry, I may sound very boring, you know, but this is a little raw emotion I speak. I don't have a written speech, so please forgive me if something has come out which doesn't matter with how you think. Hopefully, we should have more of these conversations, more of these actions. And the wine industry should take a lead in making it as sustainable as possible. Adrian is working hard. All should work hard. And we pray, and the suggestion to the mayor here, say the mayor is here, that develop a partnership between getting young kids involved. They are young leaders. I don't see them at the forefront. So Greta has to now skip her school to tell the world that, come on, look at climate change. Instead of that, they should be involved at the stage. At Mumbai, we do that. Get them on board, saying that, look what's happening to your nature. Can we do something about it? So if you continue this journey, maybe we'll leave the world in a better hand. Thank you for hearing me out. Thank you. I don't know how you say thank you in Portuguese. Muito obrigado. Thank you. God bless all.